Hi, good afternoon. Happy World Water Day. Could you please introduce yourself and share with me some of your experience of what you're missing in the discussions here today?
Okay. Well, happy World Water Day to you too. My name is Sharon Roos and I work for Plan Netherlands and I'm a WASH advisor there. And I think one of the key issues that I seem to miss here during the discussions is that everything is mainly focused on water. And of course it's World Water Day, but water is, we always talk about WASH, and it's water, sanitation and hygiene. And it always focuses on the WA and the SH seems to get forgotten. And I think it's key to also focus on sanitation and hygiene. And I think under hygiene or under sanitation, one of the main issues that keeps to fall off the radar is menstrual hygiene management. And for me, and I think for a lot of, like 25% of the world, it's 52 actually, 52% of the world, it's like, yeah, all women deal with it. And I think menstrual hygiene management is really important, and we're currently starting a program in Uganda together with a local Ugandese corporation called AfriPets. Together with Plan Uganda and AfriPets, we're starting a program, and AfriPets is a local company preparing local or making local pads from local material with local entrepreneurs, and they're making the pads themselves, and it's reusable, so you can actually use it for more than 1 year. And the project is about people getting access to these pads, and they're made at a low price. The price is around €3 and or €2.50, and people can afford that. Because otherwise they use rags, they use banana leaves, they use even dirt, I think, or mattresses. We did some research, and people are willing to invest in these products. So it's, for us, it's really interesting.
And so with the post-2015 agenda,
yeah.
You're trying to push menstrual hygiene. Are there some other, how are people reacting to this?
People tend to laugh about it. It's even within the Netherlands, if you talk about menstruation, well, even my friends, they say, oh well, yeah, it's that time of the month again, and we always use other words for having our periods. On the one hand they say, ah, oh, very interesting program, and very interesting, and on the other hand they say it's sort of hush-hush.
Okay, so what's something, a message that you'd like to give maybe to the rest of the water, sanitation and hygiene sector?
It's about, we're talking about gender equity and gender equality, and I think mentioning sanitation and hygiene. And sanitation and hygiene is one of the key issues that's being carried by, or the burden carried by women and girls. And I think focus on that, and focus on these hygiene issues, and get them out of the controversial area that they're still in. So make them known to the public and act on it.
Okay, thank you so much for this interview.
Thank you.